Peepla the Purple Butterfly here, otherwise known as Peepla 7 on Twitter and YouTube, Peepla elsewhere on the internet. My soaps located at purplebutterfly-soaps.myshopify.com, my blog, purplebutterfly-peepla.blogspot.com. And today, I am going to cut the double pack, the double batch of mango papaya. Yes. The whole place smells amazing. And I might get to see the grandson today. And that means we have to have this out the way of little hands. You know what I'm saying? So I need to cut it, put it in a carrying box, and put that box where he can't reach. I got most things where he can't reach. This needs to go in the sink because all of those little soap splatters are raw soap. Apparently, when I was making it, I forgot to put down the paper bags, but it's all right. Life happens. And I just noticed this. There's a literal spill of the orange from when I was pouring it. But it's all good. Let's move this over here. The bag escaped! The bag escaped! Yes, I am this goofy normally. One. You'll notice it doesn't have this shiny because it's now completely dry. And hopefully, completely solid. It's been exactly 24 hours. So, yeah. There's the one. And we'll just go ahead and tighten this back up while I'm thinking about it. Next hope I make with this mold, I won't be going, how come it's acting all funny? Because I have actually done that. The mango peach salsa decided it wanted to be part of the action. I guess it was to be next soap I make. Apply. Let's tighten it back up. There we go. That's how that's looking now. And you know what? It's going to be really, really hard to cut the soap without the soap cutter. Duh, I'll be right back. Don't you love when things just fall and ruin your flow? And this is little balls of soap that I've made over time. Whenever there's a small overflow, but not enough to make a whole bar of soap out of. I make a little ball out of it. Eventually, it's going to become a plant soap. And fill a mold this size. So that way, I can have all different kinds of soaps as plants. The base will be black and blue and purple, like a galaxy. That was almost too soft. Okay, let's put that corner back that I just didn't. Already out of mode now, so we must continue the cut. Not to mention the fact that it is over 24 hours old, which means if I wait any longer, I won't be able to cut. So then we'll have a soap this big. That, trust me, that's hard to, you know, wash up with. I did that on purpose. You want to see this? Let's bring you forward. And I'm crooked apparently, so let's tilt that correctly. Look at that. I'm not real sure how I did that, but
I ain't mad at it.
See, this is what I was expecting, and that's what I got. That in this wonderful scent. Yeah. Did I spoon swirl this? I thought I just did a layer pour. That might be my favorite one. But I haven't gone past those three, so I don't know yet. This looks like flowers. This looks like a waterfall. Yeah. Soap always surprises you. You never know what's in it. Even when you specifically pour a certain style, you get something different. So far, this is the only one that looks the way I intended. See a layer pearl, a layer pour from one direction to the other, and then over. But that's what I got. All these other variations that, frankly, has me floored. And there will be a soap ball. There we go with that again. I'm still not sure how that happened. Okay. And then we have the end piece that's still relatively soft. So now is a soap ball that will be part of my planet collection. the exact same way. Let's move these over. And this should be solid too, since that one was. Same time, it's the same recipe, same everything. But this one's trying to be stubborn about coming out. Come on, pretend you're Diana Ross. I'm coming now. I'm coming now. Come on, soapy, soapy. Thank you. Be stubborn on my watch. You got a bunch of people on Facebook and YouTube that wants to see you, so you can't be hiding. Yeah. A drop of pure mica. So that part will be really, really bright in that one spot. And everything else might be the pastel that I intended, but I ain't mad at what I got. Look at that. Let's line it up and take it down. Oh, come on, 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 come on. There we go. Yeah. That becomes part of this. Go in my planetary collection when it's time to make the planet soap. I used to go, oh, I can't make a planet soap. Those soaps would be too hard to cut through. And then somebody reminded me that when you pour raw soap over an embed, the soap that's under it will soften up because it's now completely covered in liquid. So then you can cut it like you normally would. So you're thinking, nothing to see here, nothing to see here, and then you turn it around. Smells like the produce department at Kroger's in the middle of summer when the papayas are freshly brought out for the customer's approval. Now the second one is doing the layer format that I poured, which is what I was expecting the rest of those to look like. So, yeah. With a couple of variations of some of the soaps being sneaky and throwing their own little spin on it. Which is all good. Yeah. There we go. This is like a zigzag. We have this side. Oh, and then I mentioned all the tops look like that. Little squirrels on them. Yeah. Okay. Wow. That's pretty. Smells amazing. Yeah. We have that side, and of course the top. Mm-hmm. Let's put you over here. Two more to go. Wow. This was not a hanger swirl. Okay, this was literally a layered pour. But look at the wispies. It looks like I did a hanger swirl in there. Which I did not, because if you look at the video before this one, you see exactly what I did. No hanger swirl, just a sideways pour. Nice. There we go. And that is all she wrote. As much of a ball as possible, and that's the new plant. Yeah, so that's gonna go right there. I'm gonna let these sit for about an hour and a half or so to get used to their new format, so all the pieces that was mushy soft can solidify, and then they're going to a curing box so that way they can cure, get hard, become the soaps we know they can be. Yeah. In the meantime, I think I'm going to go ahead and do a lather test because I got this much soap on my hands, which is enough to lather. And we'll see what's hiding in this. It says as well, and it's a creamy lather, like that. And the last thing I'm going to do is find my litmus strips. That one right there. Test it. But right now, since I can't find those strips, I'm not going to worry about it. Sure, and that's a pretty nice delivery bag. But I guess I didn't. Yeah. So we're not going to worry about it until later when it shows back up. Anyway. Whew. I just attacked my hair with a brush. It's kind of behaving. Anyway, this has been Peepla 7 on Twitter and YouTube, Peepla elsewhere on the internet. My soaps locate purplebutterfly-soaps.myshopify.com. My blog, purplebutterfly-peepla.blogspot.com. Y'all stay blessed, stay tuned. Bye now. And look, mango papaya is cut. There's 18 pieces, I do believe. Let's see. 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Okay. 18 bars exactly. Somehow I always expect it to be slightly shorter, slightly more, but I keep forgetting I get 9 bars out of each of those molds, so that's 18.
Most 5 pound molds give you 18 bars. Those are 2-3 pound molds, but it kind of breaks down with 5 pounds of soap as that format. So I get 9 out of one and 9 out of the other, and I still end up with 18. Kind of works out. Well, technically 18 and a half. So, yeah. This has been Peepla. Bye now. Oh, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Bye now. Mango papaya, y'all. It was a layered swirl. So I was expecting all the soaps to look like this. But there were a few surprises in there, like this. And this. Looking like flowers. Looking like, yeah, I got a mind of my own, sis. What you thought? Look at that. Yeah. Cure date, November 15th, 2023. Bye now.